Remember the cop who arrested a mentally ill elderly woman and broke her arm? Well, that cop faced a penalty, and the cop who watched him do it and laughed at it, well, she faces a penalty now as well. Let me remind you of the original video.
Ma'am, please stop. You want to stop, lights on, siren, stop. You just left Walmart. Do you need to be arrested right now? No, no, no. Okay, let's stop. Come on, come on.
I'm going home. Stop doing
that. No, 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 on the ground, stay on the ground.
I'm going home.
On the ground, on the ground.
I'm going home.
Stop.
I'm going home. I'm going home.
No, you're not.
Ouch.
That's okay.
Ouch.
We got you.
These Colorado cops broke her arm. They assaulted her. She was experiencing a severe episode of dementia. It was clear that she was going through an issue. She's an elderly woman. This is the best way to handle an elderly person. Well, there's an update. Now, I want to remind you, they laughed about this. Here it is. That cop who decided to laugh at this, to not intervene, well, that cop was charged with not intervening because the state legislature in Colorado recently passed a mandate to intervene law, and it is being enforced. Remember, enforcement without infraction means nothing. So infraction without enforcement, excuse me, means nothing. So there's an enforcement here. Let's put up the picture of this cop. Remember, the male officer is Officer Hop. The female officer is Daria Jalali. Officer Jalali has now been sentenced to 45 days in jail, 3 years of probation for her inaction. I think she needs a little more jail time, in my opinion, to reflect upon what she did. Not only failing to intervene, deciding to laugh at what happened, and then providing cover to the officer afterwards. This cop earlier pleaded guilty in the arrest of Miss Karen Garner in Loveland in 2020, and was initially facing up to 60 days in jail for failing to intervene. This crime was created as part of a police reform bill passed during the racial injustice and police brutality protest in 2020. Former Officer Austin Hopp arrested Garner after she left the Walmart without paying for about roughly $14 worth of stuff. Let's put up his picture, remind everybody. Loveland Police Department's finest there. Now, I'm going to show you some things that will distress you. Okay? She repeatedly, the victim here repeatedly told them she was simply trying to go home. But instead, this monster dislocated her shoulder and fractured her arm and boasted about it later. Put up his picture again. You see, what you're looking at is a class A coward. You should be heartbroken, officer, that your arrest actually broke the body of an elderly person. I'm sure you have grandparents and they are ashamed of you. How dare you act in such an egregious way on the taxpayer's dime? Hop was sentenced in May to 5 years in prison for his treatment of Ms. Garner. And Loveland settled a $3 million lawsuit. Her family has said her condition deteriorated significantly after the arrest. And now today she requires round the clock care as a result. Let me give you some more details about the cop in question today, Jalali. She apologized to Garner and her family in court. The Loveland Reporter Herald reported. She told the judge she thought Garner was intoxicated and believed Ms. Garner was only complaining about her handcuffs so she could get out of them. She said, and I quote, "I wanted to be a good police officer and my heart was in the right place, but I still came up short." Lies. Complete lies. If you wanted to be a good cop, madam, we would have seen remorse when you realized your male officer broke the body of an elderly woman. You laughed about it. You called that goodness? You joked. And then you provided cover in your official report to cover the ass of the cop and not to report the criminal action that he had done. That probably could have saved you. That may have worked in your favor if you would have done that simple thing to report a criminal act. You swore to do so. You did not. Failed. Garner's son, John Stewart, told the judge the officer had no idea of the stress, pain, and sadness the arrest has caused the entire family. "We all have choices to make in life, and all of our choices have consequences," he said. "I ask that justice be served for my mom today." The cop's lawyer said Loveland Police and another department let her stay on the job despite a pattern of poor performance recorded in her personnel files. They even did a psychological evaluation showing that this cop, Jalali, did not have the psychological makeup to act with the precision and awareness expected of police officers. What does that equate to? This cop failed her psychological evaluations and was able to remain on the force. Sounds like a negligent hire or negligent retention suit to me. All right, Ben, thoughts on this?
Yeah, I mean, one of the things that she said in that video was really, really telling to the culture that exists within police departments, because she said something along the lines of, "Well, you know, I didn't want to seem like I wasn't involved enough. Like, I didn't want to seem like I wasn't doing enough while you were literally arresting and assaulting this elderly woman." And that right there speaks to what she thinks, when she says good police officer. She wanted to be a good police officer in the sense that she wanted to participate in the brutal culture of that police department, that she wanted to be sort of a part of their community, because in a lot of police officer communities, the only lives that are of consequence to them is other police officers. And that's something that is super, super critical. Another layer to this is realistically, like, let's be real. Why are police officers responding to like petty thievery from like retail outlets? Like, I get it, right? Like, if somebody steals something from a retail outlet, that's a crime or whatever. But a lot of people are broke and a lot of people are like this elderly woman with like dementia. Maybe, perhaps, we should have a system to respond to nonviolent petty crimes like that, to follow up with people in a more social work type setting where it's like, "Hey, why did this happen? Do you need some government assistance? Like, are you struggling financially? What exactly here is going on?" Especially when it involves the elderly or the incredibly young, right? People who are marginalized and disenfranchised, they need support. And like, if it would have been anybody else responding to this, there probably would have been a lot more humanity in that response.
That's right. That's right. We need leaders, not zombies, who blindly follow the culture of whatever they are part of. We need individuals who are willing to be a public servant, not a public menace. And I'm glad that an allocation of justice has happened here. The cop who did the assault got 5 years. And the cop who failed to intervene will serve some jail time. I think it does need to be stiffer, but it sends a clear signal they are willing to enforce this mandate to intervene law that's on the books. All right.